Hey guys, and welcome back for this next installment of Academic Writing Expectations. Now, when it comes to number five, cohesion, this is something students tend to just not know how to do, miss. This is a big struggle. So let's move through this information to understand, well, what is cohesion? Well, cohesion is the use of transitions to clarify the relationship between. Let's break this down a little bit. Now, when I say clarify, all I mean is to link the ideas. Maybe you know transitions as a bridge. They are there to connect. So you are clarifying what you have written, so it's easier for your audience to understand. Now, in this case, you are clarifying the relationship. Now, when it comes to this is a relationship that could be a time relationship, location, addition, and the list goes on and on. In fact, there is a list of transitions in Blackboard that has all of these different relationships with example transitions. But what we need to know is what relationship we are clarifying between. When it comes to this idea, when it comes to transitions, we are clarifying the relationship between A and B. As simple as that. In fact, our transition is what comes between A and B. So, what is A? What is B? It varies. Sometimes A and B are sentences that need connecting, maybe within sentences by using the word and or but, or maybe across sentences by saying furthermore or in addition. So maybe we are linking sentences, or maybe we are clarifying the relationship between paragraphs. We are linking our paragraphs, maybe by saying the first reason why, the second reason why. Organizing our paragraphs so that they are cohesive, so that we understand the relationship. One comes after another. But these are the simple ideas. These are what we know and are familiar with. What we need to make sure we are doing this semester is also being cohesive between ideas. Idea A and idea B. We need to let our audience know that idea B is just an example of what I said in A. So you need to clearly communicate this through words, word choice. In fact, there's a ton of words out there. This is a copy of the list that's in Blackboard for you all to view. There's over 2,000 transition words or phrases. You just have to use them between pretty much all your sentences, definitely between your paragraphs, and so that you link your ideas. Now, when it comes to combining this information with the rule of threes, we know that we have our introduction, our information, and our conclusion. So when it comes to incorporating transitions into our writing, you need to make sure you do so between, well, all of these ideas. Your intro is at beginning, so you let us know by, well, just starting. But when you move into your information, you need to have a transition. Maybe you say to explain, or furthermore, but let us know you're moving into this info. Also, you need to make sure you transition into your conclusion, so your audience knows you are concluding. There's a whole section on that list I provided you for, well, concluding transitions. You might say something like, this might blow your mind, conclusion. Let us know in conclusion. So when you're writing in academic writing via the rule of threes, organize But make sure you include transitions. You're going to need to reference that transitions list. Give it a practice. Look in this folder for more information and help.